friends, Megan here, and this is Jesse.
Hi, everyone. Megan, guess who I saw at the park today?
Who did you see?
I saw my friend, Mateo. He used to be in my karate class a long time ago, but he stopped coming.
Oh, well, that's too bad. But I'm so glad you got to see him today.
Me too. We got to play at the park while our moms talked. We had so much fun climbing the monkey bars together today. Man, I missed him.
In today's Bible story, John, one of Jesus' disciples, saw someone he hadn't seen in a long time.
He did? Was it someone he used to do karate with?
No, he saw Jesus. The last time John saw Jesus, Jesus was going back to heaven to be with his Father. But many years later, Jesus appeared to John in a vision. Listen to the story. Like many people who believed in Jesus, John was hurt and hated because he told people about Jesus. The leader of Rome punished John by sending him to a small island. When John was on the island, he had a vision. A vision is like a dream, but John was awake. John heard a loud voice like a trumpet. The voice said, "Write on a scroll what you see. Then send the message to the seven churches in Ephesus, Smyrna, Pergamum, Thyatira, Sardis, Philadelphia, and Laodicea." John turned around and saw seven golden lampstands. Then he saw who had spoken to him. It was Jesus. Jesus was wearing a long robe with a gold sash wrapped around his chest. He had seven stars in his right hand. When John saw Jesus, he fell down at Jesus' feet. Jesus put his hand on John and said, "Do not be afraid. I am the first and the last and the living one. I was dead, but look, I am alive forever and ever." Jesus said that the seven lampstands were the seven churches. He told John to write about everything he had seen. Jesus showed himself to John. Jesus said that he is the first and the last, the living one. While Jesus was on earth, he won the fight against sin and death by dying on the cross and coming back to life. Everyone who trusts in Jesus will live with him forever.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back. I'm so glad that you came back with us today. We just finished watching that great video with Megan and Jesse and learning about John's vision of Jesus. Now, what is a vision? A vision is the same thing, kind of like a dream, except you're actually awake. Have you ever had any dreams, really nice, wonderful dreams? Well, our story today is about John. John was getting hurt, and he actually was told that he had to go on this island as punishment because he's telling people about Jesus. He's just telling people about Jesus. Let's see. Let's make an island. If you have any Play-Doh at home, let's get it out. Have you ever been on an island? An island is surrounded by water. It's got sand. Perhaps this could be our island. What do you think? There's our island. We can pretend this is all the sand around. So John is on the island. While he's on the island, he has a vision, and in the vision, he hears a voice that says, "Write on a scroll what you see." It's important for him to write on what the scroll what he sees. What is he gonna see? Let's wait and see. He sees Jesus, and he sees seven golden lampstands. But first, he sees seven churches. So we're gonna put these up here for the seven churches. Ready? One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, what are the seven churches? They have kind of funny names, but I'm going to tell you what they are. First, we have Ephesus, Smyrna. Separate them a little bit. Then we have Pergamum, These are the seven churches he's supposed to tell about. Then we have Thyatira. That's a funny one. Our next one is Sardis. Then we have Philadelphia. Thyatira is falling over. Wait a minute. We have Philadelphia and Laodicea. Those are the seven churches. Okay. So he's supposed to write on the scroll what he sees and send it to the seven churches. What does he see? He sees, first he sees, let's bring these back so we can show you what we're gonna see. Our seven churches, seven golden lampstands. Perhaps you can move the churches over a little bit. So we see one, two, can you count with me? Three, four, five, six, and seven. Seven golden lampstands, like golden candles. And he sees Jesus, and Jesus is wearing a golden sash. And in his hand, he's holding seven stars. Let's see if we can put the seven stars, okay? We have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I got all of them. Let me move the churches over a little bit more. In his hand are seven stars, seven gold lampstands. He's wearing a sash around his waist, and he's saying, do not be afraid. I am the first and the last, the beginning and the end. I am the living one. I was dead, but now I'm alive. Of course, we're talking about Jesus. Remember, Jesus died and now he's alive? So he tells him not to be afraid. Sometimes we are afraid, but we don't have to be afraid because Jesus is with us. He keeps us safe. And so, John finished writing the scroll of what he had seen, and he sent it to these seven churches. The seven lampstands, the seven stars, and the golden sash, and Jesus saying, don't be afraid, I am the first and the last. Well, let me move some of this stuff out of the way, because when John was on the island, if you've ever been to an island, you know there's all kinds of things that we see on an island. Let's see, what could we possibly see on an island? We better get this in case it gets too messy. So if you're on an island, perhaps you would see some leaves, right? Palm leaves, plant leaves. Perhaps you would see, and I know you're gonna see this right here, perhaps you would see some sand, right? Do you love playing in the sand? You go to the island and play in the sand? Remember, John was on the island. What else would he have seen? If you go for a walk on the beach on the island, you might find some seashells. Some of different colors here. Seashells. You would maybe see some snakes. It's possible. Turtles, frogs. All these things are things that you could find on an island. And it would be fun, right, to go to the island and play. Well, that's where John was, and he was there to do what God wanted him to do, and it was to write the scroll to the seven churches. Now, what are we gonna make? While John was listening, he heard the sound, a loud sound. It was so loud, it was like the sound of a trumpet. So I thought, why not make a trumpet? Just cut this shape out like this. We can color it and decorate it. How would you decorate your trumpet if you had one? Would you use markers or would you use paint? You can make it as fancy as you want. Make mine a little bit fancy. What color is your favorite color? I really like green a lot and blue because it's the color of the water and the trees and the ocean. So perhaps I would do it like that, or you could put some glitter on it. Now, since it has this tab right here, we can fold it. And we're gonna need a stapler because we've tried this before with just glue, and I don't think glue is gonna work. But we could use our tape. I have a tape dispenser here. So if you have tape, feel free to use the tape. You might need your mom or someone to help you with this little project of the trumpet. So when John heard the loud voice, it was kind of like the sound of a trumpet. When you have something like this and you talk into it, it makes your voice so much louder. So this was our story of John when he saw the vision of Jesus. Jesus looked so wonderful, just like he always does. Let me see if I have anything else for you today. I know we have our globe here because this month we're going to be talking about missionaries in Uganda. And Uganda is a country here in Africa. People listen to what God wants them to do, and they go to different places and tell the story of Jesus, that Jesus loves them. You can do that too, wherever you're at. So remember the story we've learned today. Have fun playing with island items, perhaps making a trumpet. And remember, Jesus loves you, and so do I. Until next time.
Now, family, may the Lord bless you and protect you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he look on you with favor and give you his sweet peace. You are loved.